Before we begin this video, please click on subscribe, ring that notification bell, and like, comment, and share. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Zahid Dragon. In this video, we're going to try out VRR in 120Hz. Also, we're gonna try it out by turning it off, and we're gonna see whether the 120Hz is the same with VRR on versus VRR off. And I'm also doing this as a result of some people having doubts, not to give name names and stuff, but some experts want me to prove my point of VRR working with 120Hz. And I've made some videos about 60Hz versus 120Hz and stuff, but I guess it's not enough. They want to see it working with VRR on versus VRR off to find out the differences. Like, maybe you'll find out some differences, but I think the main difference will be the local dimming. However, it's worth taking a look at if the 120Hz is working or not, and that's the reason why I'm making this video right now, to prove it, that to prove that VRR is working with 120Hz, and to see what kind of differences there are. Maybe there are some bugs or stuff, because as we've seen in the previous videos of my VRR, there were some flickering issues, especially while playing GTA 5 or some HDR games like Forza Horizon 5, which is a new game, and so it's not and also since it can be found in two games, that means it's not a game bug, it's something that's something's wrong with the TV, that's why there was some flickering. Anyway, let's get into it. First, we're gonna try it out with VRR off, because that's the default, I guess. So yeah, let's go to NVIDIA control panel to show you that I'm gonna turn off the G-Sync. So yeah, turn off the G-Sync first. I've turned it off here. I'm gonna turn it off on my TV settings by using the remote controller. Okay. We go here, channels and inputs, then external inputs, then HDMI signal format, and then since I'm using HDMI 3, this one, I'm gonna turn it off and set it to enhanced format. I mean, I can just keep it if you want, guys, but the point of the video is VRR off everywhere, so that's what I'm doing right now. I'm turning the VRR off from the TV and the PC. After turning it off, the local dimming is already turned on. If you want proof, here you go, guys. I go to brightness and you can see that auto local dimming is high. Extended dynamic range is high, which is one of the local dimming features. So let's go to Pendulum demo. Alright, now we're in the Pendulum test. First, I turned off VRR and I turned off the V-Sync to show you the difference between VRR on and off, not the V-Sync. V-Sync, we don't care about V-Sync in this test. So VRR is off, V-Sync is off. 120fps in here, 120Hz, alright. Don't get confused. All right, this is 120Hz showing the full frames, and also I'm gonna record the screen with my phone. I'm gonna show you my phone right now, and I'm gonna slow it down to 25%. It's gonna record at 240fps. All right, so this is my Samsung Galaxy S8. It has 240fps mode. And so I use that mode, and then I slow down the video to 25%, so that it shows all of the frames, every single one of them, but in slow motion, as you can see right here. Alright, so first off, we're starting with VRR off. So, as you might see here, it's looking smooth. You might find a screen tear or two, maybe even more, but it's hard to notice with while having high FPS. So yeah, it's smooth just as you would think, and yeah, everyone knows that it's rendering at it is having 120Hz. But now let's switch to VRR on. Alright, so now I'm going to turn on VRR by going back to the settings menu. Alright, external inputs, back to turning on VRR enhanced, and then going back into the G-Sync control, NVIDIA control panel right here. I have to restart it to give the setup G-Sync option. Make sure you do that if you don't know, if you're confused, and then select this just in case, select the TV, check this box, apply. Now let's go back into the Pendulum demo right now. So yeah, as you can see now right here, VRR is definitely on, and if you focus, you can see that there's no screen tears and it's smooth, just as you would expect from 120Hz mode. So I think this finally proves my point that VRR at 120Hz works. And if you still don't believe me, let's compare them side by side. Alright, so on the left we have VRR off, and on the right we have VRR on. I hope that this is enough to convince you that VRR with 120Hz is working. Because as you can see, I matched those pendulums on the right and the left off and on, and they look the same. The smoothness is the same, everything's the same, and yeah, except maybe for some screen tears on VRR off. Also, to add a little extra bonus to my proof, you can go and search Sony X900H rtings.com and you'll find this. You'll find this review, and if you scroll down, keep scrolling on the left hand side or right, you'll find this. Just keep scrolling. When you get to the motion thing that looks like blurriness, keep scrolling. All right, there we are. You see VRR, very refresh rate. Do you see what they say over there? So they have the Canada model for the X900H, and theirs works just like mine. It goes up to 120Hz. They found some issues though, just like me, they said. Like, there's some weird bugs, I guess. Yeah, you can read that, guys. I've already read it, but they say, their bug is interesting because I don't think, they say that G-Sync doesn't work for them. So I guess each region has their own issues. Well, congratulations, Sony. You made a broken, a huge mess for your TV, which was supposed to be perfect for, ready for PlayStation 5. But I'm glad that they took care of movies, TV shows, everything, HDR, PC monitor, all at once. So if you need a monitor or a TV just to sit back and relax, this one is for you. Anyway, let's continue. Alright, so I hope that this thing has finally cleared all of your doubts. I hope that you're finally convinced that VRR 120Hz is working. I hope that Sony fixes this issue in UK and releases the correct firmware for the UK model of X900H, whatever that's called. I think it's called X90H or whatever. I hope that they fix everything and they leave no issues, no flickering, no weird screen tears and stutters, and that so that everyone goes back living normally and like there isn't any weird issue. And I hope that you guys click over here or click over there to subscribe and also like this video. Make sure you comment your thoughts about this whole situation, and I hope that you can, I need your help, guys. I need you to try your best to convince HDTV that VRR is working. I tried convincing him, but for some reason he wasn't convinced. He wanted me to make VRR on and off video, so there it is. I hope you guys can tell him so that everyone can get the correct information out there, not like inaccurate information, and that they can decide whether they would buy X900H or not based on that information. And yeah, so I guess that's it for now, guys. Click over here to watch the next video, and I'll see you next time. So yeah, as a reminder, subscribe and ring the bell and all that good stuff about liking and commenting and sharing, and goodbye. See you next time.